Hi everyone, welcome you all in my classroom. Today we discussed about schizophrenia. This video helped the people who must deal with schizophrenia every day of their lives. And from this video, you know the schizophrenia very deeply. So watch it, it is a source of inspiration for all. Schizophrenia is a challenging disorder that makes it difficult to distinguish between what is real and unreal. Think clearly, manage emotions, relate to others, and function normally. But that doesn't mean there isn't hope. Schizophrenia is a brain disorder that affects the way a person behaves, thinks, and sees the world. People with schizophrenia often have an altered perception of reality. They may see or hear things that doesn't exist, speak in strange or confusing ways, believe that others are trying to harm them, or feel like they are being constantly watched. This can make it difficult to negotiate the activities of daily life. And people with schizophrenia may withdraw from the outside world or act out in confusion and fear. There are several misconceptions about schizophrenia, such as schizophrenia refers to a split personality or multiple personalities. Multiple personality disorder is a different and much less common disorder than schizophrenia. People with schizophrenia do not have split personalities. Rather, they are split off from reality. Schizophrenia is a rare condition. Schizophrenia is not rare. The lifetime risk of developing schizophrenia is widely accepted to be around 1 in 100. Third is, people with schizophrenia are dangerous. Although the delusional thoughts and hallucination of schizophrenia sometimes lead to violent behavior, most people with schizophrenia are neither violent nor a danger to others. People with schizophrenia can't be helped. While long-term treatment may be required, the outlook for schizophrenia is not hopeless. When treated properly, many people with schizophrenia are able to enjoy life and function within their families and communities. The causes of schizophrenia are not fully known. However, it appears that schizophrenia usually results from a complex interaction between genetic and environmental factors. There are three main factors: genetic, environmental, and abnormal brain structure. At first, genetic cause of schizophrenia. Schizophrenia has a strong hereditary component. Individuals with a first degree relative who has schizophrenia have a 10% chance of developing the disorder, as opposed to the 1% chance for the general population. But schizophrenia is only influenced by genetics, not determined by it. While schizophrenia runs in families, about 60% of schizophrenics have no family member with the disorder. Furthermore, individuals who are genetically predisposed to schizophrenia don't always develop the disease, which shows the biology is not destiny. Twin and adoption studies suggest that inherited genes make a person vulnerable to schizophrenia, and then environmental factors act on this vulnerability to trigger the disorder. As for the environmental factors involved, more and more research is pointing to stress, either during pregnancy or at a later stage of development. High levels of stress are believed to trigger schizophrenia by increasing the body's production of the hormone cortisol. Research points to several stress, including environmental factors, that may be involved in schizophrenia, including prenatal exposure to a viral infection, low oxygen levels during birth, exposure to a virus during infancy, early parental loss or separation, physical or sexual abuse in childhood. In addition to abnormal brain chemistry, abnormalities in brain structure may also play a role in schizophrenia. Enlarged brain ventricles are seen in some schizophrenics, indicating a deficit in the volume of brain tissue. There is also evidence of abnormally low activity in the frontal lobe, the area of the brain responsible for the planning, reasoning, and decision-making. Some studies also suggest that abnormalities in the temporal lobe, hippocampus, and amygdala are connected to schizophrenia's positive symptoms. But despite the evidence of brain abnormalities, it is highly unlikely that schizophrenia is the result of any one problem in any one region of the brain. The signs of schizophrenia are different for everyone. Symptoms may develop slowly over months or years, or may appear very abruptly. The disease may come and go in cycle of relapse and remission. Behaviors that are early warning signs of schizophrenia include hearing or seeing something that isn't there, a constant feeling of being watched, peculiar or nonsensical verbs speaking or writing, strange body positioning, feeling indifferent to very important situation, a change in personal hygiene and appearance, a change in personality, increasing withdrawal from social situation, irrational, angry or fearful response to loved ones, inability to sleep or concentrate, inappropriate to visitor behavior, extreme preoccupation with region of the occult. There are five types of symptoms characteristic of schizophrenia: delusion, hallucination, disorganized speech, disorganized behavior that are positive symptoms, and the negative symptoms. However, the signs and symptoms of schizophrenia vary dramatically from person to person, both in pattern and severity. Not every person with schizophrenia will have all symptoms, and the symptoms of schizophrenia may also change over time. Delusions. A delusion is a firmly held idea that a person has despite clear and obvious evidence that it isn't true. Delusions are extremely common in schizophrenia, occurring more than 90% of those who have the disorder. Often, this delusion involves illogical or bizarre ideas or fantasies. Common schizophrenic delusions include delusions of persecution. Belief that others, often a vague they, are out to get him or her. This persecutory delusion often involves bizarre ideas and thoughts. Delusion of reference. A neutral environment event is believed to have a special and personal meaning. For example, a person with schizophrenia might believe a billboard or a person on TV is sending a message meant specifically for them. Delusions of grandeur. Belief that one is a famous or important figure such as Jesus Christ or Napoleon. Alternately, delusion of grandeur may involve the belief that one has unusual power that no one else, such as ability to fly. Delusions of control. Beliefs that one's thought or action are being controlled by outside alien forces. Common delusion of control including thought broadcasting, thought insertion, and thought withdrawal. Hallucination. Hallucinations are sounds or other sensations experienced as real when they exist only in the person's mind. While hallucination can involve any of the five senses, auditory hallucination such as hearing voices or some other sound are most common in schizophrenia. Visual hallucinations are also relatively common. Research suggests that auditory hallucinations occur when people misinterpret their own inner self-talk as coming from an outside source. Schizophrenic hallucinations are usually meaningful to the person experiencing them. Many times, the voices are those of someone they know, Most commonly, the voices are critical, vulgar, or abusive. Hallucinations also tend to be worse when the person is alone. Disorganized speech. Fragmented thinking is characteristic of schizophrenia. Extremely, it can be observed in the way a person speaks. People with schizophrenia tend to have trouble concentrating and maintaining a train of thought. They may respond to queries with an unrelated answer, start sentences with one topic and end somewhere completely different, speak incoherently or say illogical things. Common signs of disorganized speech in schizophrenia include loose association, rapidly shifting from topic to topic with no connection between one thought and the next, neologism, made up words or phrases that only have meaning to the patient. Preservation. Repetition of words and statements, saying the same thing over and over. Clang. Meaningless use of rhyming words, such as I said the bread and read the state and fade need and the hit, such as. Next is disorganized behavior. Schizophrenia disrupts goal-directed activity, causing impairments in a personal ability to take care of him or himself, work, and interact with others. Disorganized behavior appears as a decline in overall daily functioning, unpredictable or inappropriate emotional responses, behaviors that appear bizarre and have no purpose, lack of inhibition and impulse control. Negative symptoms. That means absence of normal behaviors. The so-called negative symptoms of schizophrenia refers to the absence of normal behaviors found in healthy individuals. Common negative symptoms of schizophrenia include lack of emotional expression, an expressive face including the flat voice, lack of eye contact, and blank or restricted facial expression. Lack of interest or enthusiasm. Problem with motivation, lack of self-care, seeming lack of interest in the world, apparent unawareness of the environment, social withdrawal, speech difficulties and abnormalities, inability to carry out conversation, short and sometimes disconnected replies to questions, speaking in monotone. There are five types of schizophrenia: paranoid schizophrenia, disorganized schizophrenia, catatonic, residual, and undifferentiated. Paranoid schizophrenia. A person feels extremely suspicious, persecuted, or grandiose, or experiences a combination of these emotions. Disorganized schizophrenia. A person is often incoherent in speech and thought, but may not have delusions. Catatonic schizophrenia. A person is withdrawn, mute, negative, and often assumes very unusual body positions. Residual schizophrenia. A person is no longer experiencing delusions or hallucination, but has no motivation or interest in life. Undifferentiated schizophrenia. A person has symptoms of both schizophrenia and a major mood disorder such as depression. When the signs and symptoms of schizophrenia are ignored or improperly treated, the effects can be devastating both to the individual with the disorder and those around him or her. Some of the possible effects of schizophrenia are relationship problems, disruption to normal daily activities, alcohol and drug abuse, increased suicide risk. A diagnosis of schizophrenia is made based on a full psychiatric evaluation, medical history, physical exam, and lab test. Psychiatric evaluation. The doctor or psychiatrist will ask a series of questions about you or your loved one's symptoms, psychiatric history, and family history of mental health problems. Medical history and exam. Your doctor will ask about your personal and family health history, he or she will also perform a complete physical examination to check for medical issues that could be causing or contributing to the problem. Laboratory test. While there are no laboratory tests that can diagnose schizophrenia, simple blood and urine tests can rule out other medical causes of symptoms. The doctor may also order brain imaging studies, such as an MRI or a CT scan, in order to look the brain abnormalities associated with schizophrenia. Treatment options for schizophrenia are good, and the outlook for the disorder continues to improve. With medication, therapy, and a strong support network, many people with schizophrenia are able to control their symptoms, gain greater independence, and lead fulfilling lives. If you think that someone close to you has schizophrenia, you can make a difference by showing your love and support and helping that person get properly evaluated and treated. So, that's all for now. If you like my videos, then subscribe to my channel for more videos. And if you have any queries, you can write it as a comment. Thank you. Take care. Bye-bye.